Good morning, vlog. It's another Friday. It is October 20th. It's 8:02 a.m. I need to be headed out the door for work, but I just wanted to get this vlog started off and say good morning. So I wanted to show y'all my outfit for today because I'm feeling cute AF. Hold on, let me see if this will help. So I have this sweater here from Zara, brown cargo pants from Target, and then my New Balance. So I'm feeling just super cute for work today, and I put my hair in a bun, well, a more tamed bun, because it's just time to wash it, and it was just looking real dry, so I twisted it up and put it in a bun like this. But yeah, the outfit, yes, it's so cute. I love it. But yeah, I just want to say good morning and start the vlog off, and I will catch you guys later today. I really don't have much planned, so see y'all later. Good morning, vlog. It is Saturday, October 21st. It's 11:09 a.m. I'm getting ready to do my hair because I'm having a little spa day today. Like, I'm going to get a massage with one of my friends, and I just want to refresh my hair. Like, first of all, my hair needs to be washed, but like, and it's long overdue. Like, I was supposed to wash my hair last week and I didn't. So it actually needs to be washed, but I'm just going to refresh it, spray some water on it, and maybe hopefully Sunday I can actually do my hair for the week, like wash it for the week. But I'm actually gonna be getting my hair done on Friday this week. I'm getting a silk press, which I'm so excited about. I haven't gotten a silk press probably since like February or March. So, and typically I wouldn't get one again until February, because I just like to get my hair done in the colder months. But I'm getting it straightened a little bit sooner, just because I want to. So yeah, I'm gonna do my hair right now, and I'll get back with y'all after I'm done with my hair. Okay. I'm done doing my hair. So I thought I was going to put it back in those two little buns that I had it wrapped around, but I'm actually kind of feeling this a little bit. And I've actually been thinking about cutting my hair because, like, look how it just lays on my head, like, so flat like this. Like, before, like, it used to, you know, be a fro and stand up and have, like, a lot more volume. So I've been thinking about cutting it, and I think I'm actually going to cut it after I get my hair straightened this weekend. So I'm going to get my hair straightened. I'm going to enjoy my length, my inches, because I wear my hair curly pretty much all year. So I never really get to enjoy the length of it that much, which isn't a big deal because I prefer wearing my hair curly anyway. But when it's time to straighten it, you know, I really just take the time to enjoy the length that I have. And now that my hair has gotten longer, my curls just look different. You know, my hair just kind of lays flat because the hair is so heavy now, and my hair is going to look amazing when I get it cut. Like, when I tell you amazing, like, it's just gonna look so freaking good. And I'm excited about it, actually, because I'm, you know, I don't want my hair to lay flat like this. You know, I want it to, like, stand up and have volume. And I have to do so much manipulating to my hair to even get it to appear like it has a lot of volume. And another reason why I want my hair cut is that probably about a year ago, I cut my hair while I was taking my braids out, because first of all, I did not detangle like I should have when I was taking the braids out, which caused a huge knot to develop in my hair when I was combing through it. And I had hella gel in my hair, and it was just a mess. I don't even like to talk about it, because that was such a upsetting experience. And I literally cut my, like, a section of my hair, like, cut it to ear length. Literally, like, that's how short it was. And luckily, like, my hair so thick that it wasn't noticeable to other people, but it was definitely noticeable to me. And so now it's finally grown out to probably about, like, right here. It's grown out to there, and I'm just tired of seeing that huge gap in my hair. Although it's not noticeable to others, it's noticeable to me. It's noticeable when I'm trying to do my hair a certain way, and I typically don't like the way it turns out because of that section that's so much shorter than everything else. So I'm not going to, like, cut my hair to here. Like, no, I'm not trying to go back that far. But maybe to, like, you know, armpit length or something like that. Maybe even bra strap length. Like, I really liked my hair when it was at bra strap length as well. But honestly, we'll see what the vibe is, you know, after, how I feel after I'm done with my straight hair. Like, we'll just see what I decide when that time comes. But I know I'm cutting it for sure. And so I think this is cute right here, like this. I think I really might leave it like this. And I need them pimple patches. Like, where y'all get them from? Because I need some. I've been using the Adapalene to help with the breakouts that I was experiencing, like, on my jawline and, like, on my cheeks. And the Adapalene was, it works. Like, the texture and all of that, like, it has been slowly disappearing ever since I've started using the Adapalene. But, like, I took a break from it for, like, a day or two because, like, it was making my skin burn. Like, my skin was getting irritated from it. So I took, like, a break for a day or two, just to, you know, help my skin out a little bit. And it took that long for me to get two more breakouts on my face from that break. And then, Like, I looked into it, so, you know, they said to... Because usually I put the adapalene on and then I let it dry into my skin. But they were saying if, you know, if your skin is getting irritated by it, then put the adapalene on and then put your lotion on right after that. And so I did that and my skin stopped burning. But those 2 days that I took a break, got two new friends. And I'm not feeling that. I don't like that. And I also got topicals. Have y'all tried this? I saw it on TikTok and I was like, I mean, might as well. Because I have used vitamin C in the past, but I ran out of it. I was using Sunday Riley vitamin C serum. I was using the serum and I ran out of it. And so I just figured, like, you know, why not try something new? Like, the girls on TikTok were saying that it worked and they liked it. So, I'm going to try it out because one thing I don't want now that these pimples have been popped, I don't want the hyperpigmentation to, I don't even want it to have a chance to, like, come through at all. So, I'm actually going to put this on today and then, We'll just go from there and see. And then y'all do not forget to use sunscreen. Like, you are wild if you do not put on sunscreen every day. Like, when I was younger, I used to not put on sunscreen and I would just be so frustrated with the hyperpigmentation, but I was actually making it worse by not wearing sunscreen. Now that I'm older, like, I'm just way more serious about my skincare and, like, taking care of my skin. So, I will be putting on sunscreen after everything I use today. So, I'm going to use the faded cream first. Then, I'm going to use my Belief Aqua Bomb. And then, I'm going to go in with my sunscreen. So I'm just gonna continue getting ready for the day. I'm going to eat some, I guess, brunch. And yeah, so I'll check in with y'all later because I do have to figure out how to get this storage off my SD card to clear it so that I can continue to film. So I'm gonna figure that out in the meantime, eat some lunch, and then I'll pick y'all back up when I'm getting dressed and headed out for the day. So bye, catch you later. Okay, we're headed out to go to Massage Etoile for our massage today. So I have on Aritzia TNA set. So these are, I think these are the perfect fit pants, perfect fit cinch crop top. This is in the color Modern Taupe. And then this is a Babaton contour in the color brown. And then I have my Unique Glow Moon Bag, New Balance. And we're headed out the door because I don't want to be late. So, catch y'all there.
Gotcha. Well, we could do 6 p.m., but it would have to be available to do like the foot massage. It'll be two, you know,
they're
doing the foot massage and then...
Are you ready?
No, girl, I
know what you... Okay, phone.
Yeah, you gotta get on your phone now.
No, I have to get it.
You gotta get some on your phone.
Oh. I'm like, girl, I still got the crumbs. I'm trying to keep them out the kitchen.
What crumbs?
Oh. I'm trying to keep it out of the area.
Just for the foot massage.
Oh, okay, I think it's
going to
be
fine. Okay. Yay, cheers to a really relaxing day and girl time.
Yes. For the bottom of the couch.
Mm-hmm. They had less packages.
Yeah.
But they gave him, they gave Dante more and more and more as the days go on.
Right now, or drunk, whatever you want to call it, I'm buzzed. Me and my friend, we went to Lock and Key at Interlock. We got massages at 2 p.m. at Massage Etoile. I was actually a little late to the massage. I probably got there like 15 minutes late. But they were able to get everything done in them like 50 little minutes that we had left, because the massage was actually 60 minutes. But the massage was good. The lady was a little rough with me though. Like at the beginning of the massage, I felt like she was being like really rough, and I did not like that, because I definitely said light for my massage, not medium. I said light. So I didn't really like that at first, but overall the massage was good. So then after that, we headed to the Interlock. We went to Lock and Key. We got there around 4:15. Our reservation was for 4 p.m. So we got there at 4:15. Nobody was in there, so like we didn't even need a reservation for real. So we sat down, and our waitress was like cool in the beginning, but then afterwards, like, they just stopped coming to the table completely. Mind you, nobody was in the restaurant. There were two whole tables in the restaurant. And our waiter had two tables in the whole restaurant. And we probably sat there for like 10-15 minutes waiting for him to come back and take our order, because we were only there to get appetizers anyways, because I made a reservation for us at Humble Pie at 5 p.m. And at this point, we got there at 4:15, so we was already kind of late. And then we waited like 10 to 15 minutes for the waiter to even come back to the table and take our order, which he never did, because at this point we just sat at the bar. So the guy at the bar, the bartender, was fucking with us, okay? So when we first sat down, he was like, I don't want y'all to give me no attitude or nothing. Because, like, I know, basically, he watched us, like, sit at the table for, like, 10 minutes. And, like, the waiter did not come back to us. So, like, he saw the whole thing. So, he's like, I just don't want y'all to be, you know, mad or whatever.
It was like, no, we're fine. Like, nobody was at the bar, so like we knew that like we were gonna get decent service. And not only did we get decent service, but we got great service actually. So I don't know if he felt bad because like he saw us like sitting at the table forever. But he gave us both a free shot. It was, I saw him pour the shot, but at the time like I wasn't even thinking it was for us because there was other people. By this time other people sat at the bar. So he gave us each a shot of Casamigos. I want to say it was Reposado is the one that's like brown. He gave us shots of that, and I haven't taken a shot of nothing in like so long, so that was not easy for me to do. But luckily Reposado, it was like really smooth, so it wasn't an issue at all, you know, throwing it back. But I was drunk. I felt like real tipsy after that, and I ordered their crab cakes. The crab cakes was good. I've never had crab cakes before. That was my first time. They were delicious, and they came with like a Cajun aioli sauce. It was so good. And then I ordered a lemon drop, which was good as well. And then we had a reservation for Humble Pie at 5 o'clock, but we did not get to Humble Pie probably until like 5:30, which is fine because like Humble Pie wasn't even busy for real either. I was kind of surprised by the places we went to, like none of them were busy, because y'all know in Atlanta, like if you don't have a reservation, like why you even go, right? But that was not our experience at all today. Like every place we went into, like we had a reservation, but it really wasn't necessary. So that was my first time at Humble Pie. The pizza is so good. I didn't even finish all the pizza. I took like one slice and I was done after that. I got the truffle fries as well. So the pizza was good. I had a great time hanging out with my friend and like catching up with her and just hanging out. And I can't wait to do it again. I will definitely be back to Humble Pie for sure. I think next time I go to Lock and Key, maybe I'll go like on the nighttime vibe, because the restaurant on the inside, it looked like a nighttime vibe. Like it didn't really give me like daytime lunch type of restaurant. It gave me night vibes for real. And let me tell you, both the places we went to, the music was A1. The music was so good at both the places that we went to. Like playlist was like top tier. Like every song they play, like singing it, wanting to dance, get up out my seat. So I just really had a great time today. And then when we got to Humble Pie, like we had another drink. Like I haven't drank that much in a while, and I know you're like, you only had like a shot and two drinks, but that's a lot for me, because I used to drink like every weekend, like a glass of wine or something, but I really backed off of that for like the past couple months. So this is kind of a lot for me. But yeah, I had a great time, and I can't wait to go back to those places in the future because the food was good. What else? So tomorrow I'm gonna hang out with my friend, and we're actually gonna make pizzas, which is crazy because like I got pizza today. So I don't know, we'll see if we'll still make pizzas tomorrow. But I'm excited about that. And these two pimples on my face are killing me. Like they're disgusting. I wish I would have popped them last night and, you know, let them dry out overnight, but I just didn't do it. And when I did it this morning, like, that was a mistake. That was a mistake because they've just been looking swollen all day.
and I should have just popped them last night so they could be dry by the time I woke up. And like, I need another facial at this point. Like, I need a facial because my skin has been acting up. Like, that's a whole nother story, like with birth control and like all that. Like, my skin has just not been cooperating with me, and I got the Adapalene to like kind of control it. And them 2 little days that I was not using the Adapalene, like, I get 2 new pimples. It's really frustrating. And then I don't even have like the skincare that I need with me right now. So I don't even know what's gonna happen to these pimples. I'm hoping that but yeah, I'm going to call it a night, you guys. I'm like so sleepy from those drinks. So I'm going to call it a night, and I will see y'all tomorrow when I'm hanging out with my friend and making pizzas. Good night. Good afternoon. It's 1 o'clock. It's Sunday, October 22nd. I've just been chilling this morning, relaxing because last night was really fun. But I'm actually about to get ready to go to my friend's house so we can make pizza and cinnamon rolls. I still haven't even ate the pizza that I bought yesterday. But yeah, we're gonna get dressed and get ready to go because I don't want to be late like I was yesterday. I'm trying to get better at being on time. So the outfit for today, I have these All in Motion leggings from Target, my Aritzia TNA cropped shirt. I'm gonna wear this jacket again, the TNA cinch fleece jacket. I'm going to wear cream socks, and then I'm going to wear my New Balance that I've been obsessed with. So all neutrals again, and this is a Skims top, and I'll probably wear the Skims underwear too. And I haven't even worn these leggings yet. Like, the tag is still on them. And I bought a cute little workout bra to go with this brown as well. But it got cold out. Like, when I bought this stuff, like, it was getting colder outside. So I really should have been buying like windbreakers to go with my workout clothes. But anywho, we're going to get dressed and get ready to go. I think I'm going to record another TikTok of like getting ready. Me, I didn't really like the one that I did yesterday, so we're gonna try it again today and see if I like it better. So I'll catch y'all when I get to my friend's house. All right, here's the whole outfit together. I'm just been loving the neutrals. This is probably the best thing I ever did for myself and like my wardrobe, just buying like a whole bunch of neutrals so that like you just always look good and put together. So this outfit is so freaking cute to me, and let's get ready to go. It's 1:11. It's gonna take me like 50 minutes to get to my friend's house, so I will see y'all there. And still carrying my Uniqlo moon bag as well. So catch y'all there. Yeah.
Chapter 2. Let's rock.
Can you rock the mic?